Thanks for watching Chittarupa Yoga and Fitness. I'm Laura Wilson, and we're going to be doing another pranayama exercise today, or breathing exercise. This is one that you want to be very considerate of yourself with. It's called Kumbaka, which means breath retention, or holding our breath. Now, for a lot of people, as soon as you start to hold your breath, your body goes into that panic mode. So if that's you, you can just skip this particular video. I, on the other hand, when I'm holding my breath for a few seconds, I actually start to relax a little bit. So if you're not sure, give it a shot. If you find that it is relaxing for you, you're about to learn something that might enhance your pranayama or breathing practice. But again, let's go ahead and just begin with a deep inhale and just hold our breath. Noticing how our body responds. Let it go. So here again, if you started panicking and your body just wanted to go, or once you let go, your body went, this may not be the breath practice for you. All right? If, however, it felt okay, let's begin with any kind of breathing that you want. Expanding, lifting, lowering, three-part breath, belly breath, and let's just take a few regular breaths, whatever that means today. So breath retention, or Kumbaka, can be done after the inhale, and that's when most people do it. So let's go ahead on our next inhale, hold our breath for a couple of seconds, and exhale. And again, we'll inhale, hold, and you can hold it as long as you want, exhale. So let's just do three more rounds right here at our own pace. So another place that we can hold our breath is on our exhale, which again could send us into that panic mode because we've exhaled all of our air. Most people inhale, fill up with oxygen, so you've got some reserve. You still have reserves on the exhale. Your lungs never actually completely go without oxygen. There's always still a little bit left. So keep that in mind. Hopefully you won't go into that panic mode. Let's add the breath retention at the bottom of our breath or on the exhale as well. See how that works for you, okay? Let's inhale, hold. And exhale, hold. Inhale, hold. Exhale, hold. Three more rounds on our own. Return to normal breathing. So I'm feeling myself relaxing a lot right here. All right. So some ways that we can play around with that. We never want to hold our breath when we're in a pose. So if we're ever holding a pose or doing any kind of exercise, a lot of people will hold their breath like when doing a chest or any upper body exercise. That's really not good for you. The best time to do it is like we're doing right now when we're in a regular breathing practice, preferably on the floor or a chair in case you get dizzy. It's not a smart call. We can also practice this lying down on our backs in shavasana. And we might do that one day. I'll keep that in mind. But another thing that we can do, we can take this to different levels personally by holding our breath for longer periods of time as we grow more comfortable with this practice. Today, I'm going to talk to you just a little bit about doing this in like an equal ratio breath, and there's a video on equal ratio breath. So inhaling to our own personal count of four, as we deepen our practice, we can take that to six. Then we're going to hold for half of that. So if we inhale four, we want to see if we can hold for two, exhale for four counts, hold for two if we're holding at the bottom of our exhale. Once we get a little better at this, we can expand our breath to 6 counts, and then 2 or 3 counts for the holds. Exhale 6 counts, 2 or 3 counts for our hold. I personally like to go ahead and find my own heartbeat so that I know the count is steady, rather than trying to count to myself. It might not always be consistent, but my heartbeat should be pretty consistent. So if you want to practice this, give it a shot. Just go for 4 right now. Inhale for 4 counts or 4 heartbeats. Hold for 2. Exhale for 4. And hold for 2. So let's just do that a few rounds, getting in touch with our own body here. Turn to normal breathing. So revisit this video as you work with Kumbaka, or holding your breath retention, and try, you know, doing a little bit more each time. As with all things, any kind of breathing practice or physical practice in our yoga, the more we do it, the better it gets, the more comfortable it gets. And then the more we're able to expand out and maybe hold poses for a little bit longer, hold our breath for a little bit longer, expand the length of our inhales and exhales a little bit longer. So work with this, see what happens. I'd love to hear what you have to say about that in the comments. Let me know through comments here or in emails. Let me know what your personal experience with this particular pranayama practice is. All right.